Greetings, Idrin. All praise King Selassie. Talking about this concept called prioritized struggle. It is prioritized because our high people and all people's priorities are being set. Obviously, the Babylonian man seeks for us to expend our energy on struggles that do not affect him negatively. For example, abortion, BLTG, homosexuality, women's rights, which are not unimportant. It's just that everyone is aware that women have not had rights, and some people are aware of why this is. In the past, it was seen, it was admired for one man and one woman to join together in holy matrimony and form union. This was recognized as one body, given one right to vote. If the same man and the same woman were not joined in matrimony and yet worked together, they could achieve two votes. So, regardless of what you or I believe, you know, the respect was given to one individual to eliminate that advantage that people would have had they not been married. I believe that women are equal to men. I believe that women are in danger because of men. And I believe that the whole struggle of feminism is mischaracterized so that it is no longer an effort to safeguard women against exploitation, yet it has now become an effort to exploit women, so that the people that are viewed as feminists are the ones not only being exploited, but setting the tone, the role to as an example for other women to exploit themselves. And again, it comes back to the promotion of capital. The dollar bill in the United States, other currency elsewhere. This is the main mechanism in which the ruling classes continue their state of domination over all the earth. And because of this, these individuals are conspiring to take the attention off and divert us into these other prioritized struggles. We can fight for many things, but it doesn't always come out right. Perhaps a bit discombobulated. And so, if we focus on one effort, at least at a time, we are more likely to achieve more satisfactory results. If there are certain issues that cannot and will not be solved, such as abortion. There's all this talk now about this law of Roe versus Wade, and it's going away, you know, so that people can restrict women from having abortions. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. They're going to turn this into a big struggle, a battle that people will jump in and waste their lives fighting. And it is not going to get us anywhere. We have to focus on what can be achieved. What are the facts? What can we unify around? And that basically comes down to class, capital, and the differences. The divisions and the inequalities of which. And obviously, this has been a struggle that has existed far before abortion and homosexuality and women's rights ever became issues. And so, over the centuries, man has learned to defect the freedom fighters and prop up his illusion of what freedom actually is. So, what is it, we must ask, that the ruling classes would like and that the earth would like? Would they like for all to be homosexual? Would they like for all to have abortions? And if that were the case, and those problems were solved, right, because everybody's homo and having abortions now, and dressing like women, you know, what would be the next struggle? And we, it's fair to assume that that's not gonna happen in our lifetime, although the world is moving towards that path. It's not gonna happen in our lifetime, and the problem of class is still going to exist. To me, it is a problem that's easily definable. You have individuals that have wealth that exceeds the wealth of others in almost immeasurable terms, so that although we may be able to count how much pennies these folks have in their bank account, we'll never know what it is to have the technologies, the network, the support, the knowledge, right, of how to oppress others throughout the ages. I mean, all these are added attributes to someone in that position that are not necessarily measurable. And so, if you think about the ability for somebody in that position to survive versus the ability of somebody of normal financed individual to survive, you can see where not only do the ruling folks have the advantage from the beginning, yet they continue to have the advantage. Like, if you have somebody with an advantage and someone with a disadvantage, what humanity tries to do is give the person with the disadvantage, you know, the support, give them the extra tools, and take it away from the advantage because they're already advantaged. So, you know, it's easy to spell out what the problem is. It may be more difficult to solve, and yet that doesn't matter. What matters, the first step is knowing that there is a problem and this is what it is. I don't think that people have clearly defined that. People have not clearly defined that. And as we move into the future, these people, the ruling classes, have more advantages, greater advantages that they never had, ever. You know, mass surveillance, be able to check, you know, what you know, to organize and sort and make a visual of what people's behavior is, and have the wherewithal to change those behaviors, to, you know, have satellites and all this that the ruling classes possess, even the chip. All the institutions that are pushing out all the media and information, that's the ruling classes. How many people do you know, average people, that own media outlets? Even little newspapers, let's say. I know one. So, the ruling classes control what people see. And that's power. If you had a system that really worked, that was really democracy, you would have the ownership of those assets in the hands of the majority, the ones that are disadvantaged. So, that's not what we have. And the ruling classes know it. They know their whole thing, their system works for them. It doesn't work for us, and they use our energy to protect themselves. If you think about the feudal system, you had the castle, it was on the hill, it was surrounded by the moat, it had those towers, and those arches would sit up there. What was all that for? That was to protect the king and the queen and the royalty. Who ran things, they controlled things. They were the slave drivers of the feudal days, the Middle Ages. And as time progressed, things did not change. They evolved. We began this the state of mass African slave trade, which has become the state of mass incarceration. Someone benefited from these centuries, 400 years, and this was the beginning of the international system of Babylonian law. Some call it New World Order. You know, this is basically where you sit in your castle, surrounded by your walls and your guards, and you force others into conditions where they are slaves. They're modern day slaves because they are barely making enough to survive. And they may believe that they're getting something out of life because they have some new gadget, but these products are made from your companies, and it's planned obsolescence so that the products are placing people into a further continuous state of perpetual slavery. Continuing to have to buy and sell to survive. And every time that currency and those products and services are traded, you benefit. You, the king, the ruling class, the oppressor man. So, this slavery, mass incarceration, and on to today, where people are digital slaves, giving their information to people. For example, you know, the companies are looking at people's information and they're saying, well, I want this person to work, they're a perfect slave. Leaving all the rest of us behind. Now getting to the topic of prioritized struggle. So the Babylonian man seeks for the multitude to fight for causes that will not adversely reflect onto him. And he also illuminates certain individuals that he knows are perfect servants to his system. Because if somebody wants to change themselves into a woman and they want to look at pornography and hire prostitutes, they're looking at the world and they're going, this is a great place. You know, it used to be really oppressive against, you know, us. Now, this is a wonderful place to be. Because, you know, we can do these things and become this new human and even have sex with robots, right? So these people are fighting for this freedom. It's really not freedom. They are slaves to sin, as Paul would say. And yet, it's these individuals that are getting the support. They're getting propped up on Shitter or Face Crook or Snoople. And they're made out to be some kind of, you know, special heroes, talents, and so on and so forth. Now there's an effort to get more people active in social media, especially on YouTube, because the Babylonian man sees where his servants have become consumed, utterly consumed, and so they're kind of a waste, yeah? And they're not really projecting his image as he would see fit. So now you've got a different breed coming along, speaking out, bringing the truth to surface, and the Babylonian man said, no, we got to cover that up. We need more and more and more people spreading lies. So this ties in because, again, these are the struggles that the Babylonian man is looking for the majority to see. What we see is what we'll think about. What we hear is what we'll think about. No one can hear two messages at once. So the Babylonian man constantly trying to feed these messages, whether it be on the television, whether it be on the radio, whether it be on the side of a bus. Babylonian man is finding a way to feed his message. And if an individual, let's say, may represent Rastafari, and yet that individual may be spreading lies, you better believe the Babylonian man gonna put him on. So, there's a reason why Ras doesn't get very many views. And maybe Ras will get views in the future. Who knows? The Babylonian man, perhaps. Certainly, Haile Selassie, I am at the first. And we have to let, I and I have to let Babylonian man know we know. Because, see, the Babylonian man counting the I and I man for slackness in this time, saying the I and I man don't really know, the I and I man smoked out, or whatever, right? The Babylonian man has all kinds of twisted misconceptions. And so the I and I set it straight and let the Babylonian man know. You can't get it by us. You may be able to trick the multitude, yet the I am man stand for a reason, giving thanks unto His Majesty, the King of Kings.